G'day all, MrPaladin here, and today I'm looking at the red tape recorder. It's a new sapper for the spy. And you know, as Sung Tzu says, you've got to know your enemy. So we're going to start out as an engineer, and we're going to have a look at how long it takes for a regular sapper first to work on a sentry gun, and a teleporter, and a dispenser. So you can see the timer countdown at the top, but as well as destroying the sentry gun, a regular sapper will actually damage the gun. The new red tape recorder does not do that. So switching to the spy, I allow Monk to build up to level 3, and when he's ready to go, I sap his stuff up. Sap the sentry right at 50. You can see in the meter in the top left how long it's taking to sap those teleporters. But let's see, it's 40 now and the sentry gun's still not down. Okay, it just went there, so it was a good almost 15 seconds to take out the level 3 sentry. And it wasn't until 26 that the dispenser and the teleporter went down. So, changing out to engineer again, I went to the gunslinger because I wanted to see how the gunslinger would react to this new sapper. Removing the sapper off the dispenser, then I remove it off the sentry gun right before it was about to finish, and you see it comes back. It does its quick deploy, but it comes back to full health. You'll also note the red sapper on the ground. That can actually be picked up for a minor amount of metal. Okay, and then I ask him to sap it all up again. Sap, not cloak, come on. Okay, there we go. And the amount of time it takes even to destroy the mini sentry, which is kind of good because I can't redeploy another mini sentry while this one's being sapped. And it creates a cute little toolbox, look at that. Oh, anyway, yeah, you'll see it takes about the same amount of time with the gunslinger to destroy the teleporters and the dispenser. So, I have a quick look at this disabling effect on the level 3 sentry gun one more time, and I let it get sapped down to level 1, and then I remove it, and look how long it takes to redeploy. It's the same as if it's the build time. I mean, it's still not ready, and even when it comes ready, it's down from a level 3 to a level 1. And right before the teleporter gets destroyed, I remove the sapper from it, but look at it, it's taking a horrendous amount of time to become active. If your team's relying on this teleporter, I mean, that sap's perfect for it. Even if the sapper gets removed, it's back down to a level 1. Okay, MrPaladin, how does this relate to real-life gameplay? Well, it took me a while to find an engineer in the games I was playing. And in this capture point game on Badlands here, I was doing some Saharan with the Red Sapper. And I just stabbed a soldier, and he comes out of spawn and sees me right as I see the sentry nest. The engineer probably took his teleporter because he vanished. I get a refill of my cloak off that dispenser, and I've got to stay close and patrol for this engineer to come back. The soldier comes back down and I've got his disguise, so I'm watching him as well. You're able to watch the sentries go down, and your team's able to take advantage of the sapped buildings, and you saw a heavy come on in there. And this is another situation. I'm sorry, the recording was showing me flicking my cloak, but I wasn't doing anything of the sort. I had the cloak up the whole time. I was replenishing off of his dispenser, but I saw him step away and I knew he was going to come back, so I go for the stab and then the sap, and the stab and sap is going to be my preferred choice with this recorder because of the amount of time it takes for the stuff to go down. You'll see I come on down, I have a go for the payload. There was a party mode or a disco mode on, making all the lights and the payload go funny here, and they're calling out for spy. They saw me. And in these last few moments of this clip, I'm going to slow it down for you, and you'll see that the engineer has come out of spawn and he's inspecting his stuff just before it goes down. So thanks for watching. That was the red tape recorder tutorial. Shout out to Monk and MarkBot500.